When that music comes on, signifies that Luchie will be there. And guess what? Good morning, Luchie.
Good morning, Phil.
And it's chilly weather today.
I don't know. I'm up in Sydney.
Are you? Oh, yeah. Right.
Guys, here after 3 days of rain.
right. Well, it's 11 degrees down here, so the family's enjoying some warm weather compared to Sydney.
I'm up here by myself.
Oh, right. Okay. You're cooking up a storm again?
Yeah, we've got another meat stock on, so we're up here for the Sydney version.
Oh, right. So we're going to have a look at some soup today.
Yes, it's probably apt because all I've eaten is meat for the last 3 days. Veggie soup's probably good.
Now, we're a multicultural society down here, and we live... is there a difference between the vegetable soup that we know from history and the minestrone soup?
Sorry, Bill, just broke up a little bit there.
Oh, right.
Difference between vegetable soup and minestrone?
Yeah, is there a great difference there?
Yeah, look, I think all minestrone, or pretty much all minestrone, are vegetable soup, but not all vegetable soups are minestrone.
That's so, clarified things.
The biggest difference really is that, like, minestrone is like a very hearty soup. It's, very chunky, has lots of different vegetables in it, and generally will have pasta or maybe rice and beans. And that's kind of what separates it from most other vegetable soups. So it's always chunky, has beans and pasta and rice.
Oh, pasta and rice. Okay.
Yeah, or either or.
Because Mum used to put pearl barley or something like that.
Oh, yeah, pearl barley is a great one, but that's probably more of a Australian take on a minestrone.
Oh, right. Okay, so they both taste good.
Grain or some kind of, starchy thing in there.
Yep.
Go with all those veggies. So just give it some body, more texture.
And, right, so what are the basic requirements you need to make soup?
So pretty much any soup starts with a liquid. So you can use water, but it's not going to be very tasty. So some stock, whether that's chicken or vegetable, they're the kind of two main ones. If you're making like a bisque or something, you might use a seafood stock. But chicken or vegetable stock are the heart for most soups.
Right. And preparation of the, most of the soups are made from vegetables, aren't they?
Yeah, well, you can add some meat, some protein to it, but it's a great, at its core, soup was a way to use up leftovers. You had some leftover vegetable scraps from making something else, and without letting anything go to waste, how do you turn that into a meal? Because maybe you have, six or seven different things, not enough for one, meal of roast carrots or something. So you add that with the other scraps, and you mix it all together in a pot and boil it, and you make a soup, and you extract the most amount of nutrition out of it.
Right, I didn't realise that was how it all started. Wow.
I wasn't there. I could only guess.
Right. So when you're making these, you do all your preparation. If you're not using up scraps, so to speak, preparation of your vegetables, get them all ready. And what do you do with them then?
Yeah, look, it's a little bit depends on what you're cooking, what soup you're making. If you're making something like a minestrone, you'd start off with a stock for your base. So if if you've got the time, you've got the energy, it's always going to taste better if you can make your own vegetable stock or chicken stock. And that's pretty easy to do. It's just putting some scraps in a pot with some water and simmering them for an hour or so.
Boil them down.
If you're doing chicken, it's a little bit longer.
Yep.
But you can also add more flavor by roasting or searing off cooking those vegetables before you add the water. So if you get some good sear, some good color on them.
Yep.
Add some tomato paste, they'll always add more flavour to it. So that's a great way to boost up the boost up the base.
Right. And then if you haven't got the stock, you just buy it?
Yeah, you can just buy it. If you buy the cheaper stuff, it's not quite as good. If you buy the fancy stuff, it will make a difference. And then depends what you're doing. If you're making minestrone, it's all about texture. So you want to make sure you're adding your vegetables to that stock in an order that they're going to cook. So chunkier root vegetables going first, and then softer, things like spinach leaves, things like that, going towards the end so that you have everything cooked nicely rather than really crunchy pieces of undercooked carrot or potato and, overcooked mushy pasta.
Right.
But if you're making, you know, a soup that you're going to puree at the end of it, that's less important. You want everything cooked so it's all soft and it blends up.
Uh-huh. Right. Now, talking about combinations of soups, I've had things like potato and leek, chicken and corn, broccoli and cheddar. There must be others that we can look at using the veggies out of the garden. But how do you decide what goes with what without one over dominating the other or making it taste terrible?
I think you just try to look at, you know, the overall flavour profile of what you're cooking. So if you were doing something creamy like potato or cauliflower, you might add something to that to kind of boost the flavour, because, you know, cauliflower or potato, as tasty as they are, they can be a little bit bland.
Yep.
You know, they're not the standouts. They're the backbone of it.
So
you know, that's why we add leek to potato soup. You know, if I'm making cauliflower soup, I really love roasting off my cauliflower first with some spices, some cumin, some coriander, smoked paprika. Put them in a pan and roast them in the oven with some onions and some carrot and get that colour, that char on them already.
Mm-hmm.
We add them to the soup. We've added that extra flavour to the soup.
And the you just cut my mustard there. So how do you get the smoky and spicy and chili style soups?
Yeah, so, you know, if you want that smoky flavour, the best way is to kind of roast or sear or barbecue your vegetables before you put them in. You know, if you're going to add eggplant or capsicums, roast them on a barbecue first, get that char in there, and you'll get that smoky flavour added in straight away. And then, you know, if you want chili, generally with chili, it cooks off the heat. So the later you add the chili, the kind of more vibrant the heat will be.
Vibrant.
So, you know, if you add some cayenne pepper or some chili pepper, yep, to your vegetables when you're roasting them or searing them off or whatever, you'll get a nice kind of subtle heat. If you add chili oil or, you know, fresh chilies right at the end, that will be way brighter and hotter.
Because that was the next question. How do you balance it off so that it, some people like it hot, some people like it mild?
Well, I think one of the good things, especially with a puree soup, which is, you know, very homogenous, doesn't have much texture to it, is adding back some texture kind of as you serve it. So, you know, that might just be you add a little bit of cream or butter to it to, mm-hmm, give it like a bit of creaminess.
Yeah.
And that could be coconut cream or it could be dollar cream or it could just be a splash of milk. Or you could add, you know, croutons or crispy shallots or fried onions. Any seeds or nuts like pepitas or sunflower seeds, and even just fresh herbs, whether it's parsley or coriander or chilies, and just add them at the end, and it gives you that great, like, vibrant colour on the plate,
mm-hmm,
and some texture and some, you know, some very, very texture in there when you eat them.
And as I said, what are some of the other combinations you can think of that you've made over the years?
Yeah, look, potato and ham. Or bacon in there,
yep,
or even like crispy prosciutto.
Oh, pea and ham.
Tongue-tied there. Yeah. Yes, some vegan ham if you must.
Yeah.
They're great. But, you know, some sweet roast capsicum always goes well in there. Spinach and anything bright and green. You know, I love split pea and ham soup. That's one of my favourite. You can add some potato to that as well to kind of bulk it out, make it a little bit creamier.
Blitz those as well?
Yeah, look, you can do a bit more chunky style. You can really puree it if you're getting closer to your age, Bill. You know?
Take it through a straw.
That's it. Or if you have young kids.
Yeah. So what about something with beetroot? What would you put with that?
Oh, you could make a classic borscht, you know, chilled beetroot soup from Ukraine and Russia. Not very wintry.
But they're summer soups.
Yes, definitely. You know, you've got gazpacho and borscht and those kind of things that are really bright, light dishes and not really in the, you know, the winter warmers, but they're fun and something a bit different.
Yeah, well,
you've got to watch out eating beetroot soup because you'll stain every pair of clothes you've ever owned.
Exactly. And I love beetroot, particularly on salad.
Yes, it's great. Yeah, great in salad. Yeah, but probably wouldn't make a warm beetroot soup.
No, not at all. Well, and what's one of the crazy combinations that you've done?
I'm trying to think. I suppose that's a thing, like, you know, just about anything can be blitzed up and you can technically call it a soup, but that doesn't necessarily mean you'd want to eat it. I think one that's a little bit left field is like making like a white chili. So if you've ever had chili con carne,
yep,
you can do like a soup version of it essentially and just kind of thin it out with some chicken stock rather than adding, you know, tins of tomato and tomato paste to it.
Yep.
Just use chicken stock and thin it out, a bit of cream, and then you can still add your kidney beans in there. You can still add some like crumbled mince in there, and it's just a bit of a different dish. I hope we're not going to miss the most important part of soup. So, Bill, sorry.
The eating part?
Crusty bread.
Oh, bit of ciabatta bread.
I think that's the whole point of soup, isn't it? That you get to eat bread with it.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. So I like the sourdough and I like this ciabatta and anything that's got a good crust on it.
Yeah, that's it. Again, it's like I was saying about adding texture back to it. Yeah. And that's, you know, soup, if it is a pureed one, even a minestrone, it can be a little kind of, for want of a better way of saying it, boring to eat because it's all the same texture.
Yep.
So that's, you know, adding some crusty bread, whether it's sourdough or Turkish bread or ciabatta rolls or something, just kind of gives it something different.
Yeah. I can remember my grandfather sitting there with bread and cutting the slice off in those days because they didn't have sliced bread. And he'd cut the slice off and then tear the bread up and put it into the soup. Have you ever had that?
It broke up just as you Sorry, Bill.
My grandfather used to have the bread and he'd cut a slice off and then he'd break the slice of bread up, crust and all, and put it into the soup.
And make like little croutons for it?
Yeah, but it was fresh.
Yeah. It's something my grandma used to do similar as well. She used to make pastina, which is just like a really simple chicken noodle soup, kind of.
Yep.
Using like rizzoni or the little kind of rice pasta. Yeah, little kid's favourite.
Yeah.
And so, yeah, break up some bread in there and put that in there just to kind of bulk it out.
Yeah. And Mum, when we were sick, used to make up a meat broth. I can't remember what it was called now, but it was very thin. And it had a meat flavour to it, and that was supposed to perk you up when you were sick in bed.
Well, yeah, there's, you know, those kind of thinner kind of broth-based soups, very healthy for you. You know, you've got your simmering bones taking out all those nutrients out of them, and then you get to eat them. You know, we don't normally get to eat bones and the marrow that's inside and that kind of stuff, so breaking them down in the soup, get all those health benefits.
It's a bit like meat stock. You cook the tomahawk steaks and you sit there and the only thing you can't eat is the bone.
Yes, exactly, yeah. That's what you want.
All right, mate. Well, I better let you go because you've got to kick off the coals.
And yes, got to go get the barbecue fired up today.
Yeah, and have a great day up there, and may the rain stop.
Yes, I hope it's good because we've got to pack up as well today.
Okay, no worries at all. All right, thanks for coming on today, even though you are in Sydney, and we won't hold that against you, but thank you very much.
Thanks for having me, Bill.
All right, man, happy cooking.
Cheers.
Bye for now.